This is a very standard quadratic equation application. Check this out. We have a bottle rocket on the ground and we are going to launch it and it's going to go up vertically and we also assume that there's no air resistance. And the height of the rocket is given by this equation and the height h is measured in feet and the time is measured in seconds. So again, bottle rocket is just like the marker. It's going to go up like this and then you know it's at some point it's going to fall down. All right, so hold up. Okay, part A. We are going to find the height of the bottle rocket after 2 seconds. Well, we can just put the 2 into the T and work that out. So this is just asking us to get H of 2, and that will be negative 16 times 2 squared plus 160 times 2. And if you work that out, you will get 256. And because this has a story behind it, so make sure you include the units as well. 256 feet. That's the height of the rocket after 2 seconds. Now, part B, when will the rocket return to the ground? Well, returning to the ground means that the height is at zero, right? The height is at zero, that's the ground level. So in this case, we are going to make h of t equal to 0 and then solve for t. So we're looking at 0 is equal to negative 16 t squared plus 160 t. So we just have to solve this quadratic equation. And notice that both of them have the t and also the 16. And usually when we have the negative in front, that's just going to factor that out as well. So we get 0 is equal to factoring out the negative 16 t. We will just get positive t here. And we took out the negative already, so it would be a minus here. 160 divided by 16 is 10, and the t is out already, so that's pretty much it. So here, we put negative 16 t to be 0, and we also put t minus 10 to be 0. Divide negative 16 on both sides, this means t is equal to 0, and t is equal to 10 after we add 10 on both sides. So when will the rocket return to the ground? When t is equal to 0, it was on the ground already. So I will just say after 10 seconds. Right, this value, that's all. Now for the third part, we are going to find out the maximum height that the rocket can reach. So how do we do it? This is an open upside down parabola, right? So we have the vertex formula. The maximum is going to be at when t is equal to negative b over 2a. B is 160, so we have negative 160 over 2 times a. A is negative 16. All right, so if you multiply this out, this is negative 32. And if we divide all together, we'll just get positive 5. So when t is equal to 5, we'll get to the maximum. In fact, you see that originally it was on the ground, right? Time is equal to 0. After 10 seconds, it's going to drop back down. Right in the middle, that's where the maximum happens. Yeah. All right, so you could have also used that, but suppose if you didn't do that, then use the vertex formula right here. We want to find the maximum height though, so we will have to put a 5 into the t here and t here. So this is only the maximum at. Right, so I will just say the maximum height is going to be at h when t is equal to 5, and that's negative 16 times 5 squared and then plus 160 times 5. Work that out, you will get 400. And again, let's attach a unit for this. So the answer for this is 400 feet. Yep. Pretty cool. And if you want to see what a bottle rocket is, you can go ahead and YouTube it and you'll see that it's actually pretty cool. I have never played one before myself. If you have, let me know. That's it.